which is that if your family was still in that $40,000 home, it's now worth $3.5 or $4 million.
All right, let me just kill you right now.
Okay, go for it.
Because there was a bullshit article in New York Times saying the good of gentrification. I don't believe that. Here's the thing. I grew up here in Fort Greene. I grew up here in New York. It's changed. And why does it take influx of white New Yorkers in the South Bronx, in Harlem, in Bed-Stuy, in Crown Heights for the facilities to get better? The garbage wasn't picked up every motherfucking day. When I lived in 165 Washington Park, PS20 was not good. PS11, Rothschild 294. So why the police went around? When you see white mothers push their babies in strollers 3 o'clock in the morning to 125th Street, that must tell you something.
And I don't dispute it.
Whoa. And even more. Let me kill you some more.
I'm coming back. Can I talk about that?
No, not yet. And then comes the motherfucking Christopher Columbus syndrome. You can't discover this. We've been here. You just can't come and vote for it. They were broken to stand motherfucking action drums in Mount Forest Park for 40 years. Now they can't do it anymore because the new inhibitors said the drums are loud. My father's a great jazz musician. The Liberty bought a house in 1968, and the motherfucking people moved in next year and called the cops on my father. He's not even playing the lead, he's playing electric bass. It's acoustic. we bought the motherfucking house in 1960, motherfucking 8. And now, you call the cops in 2013? Get the fuck out of here. Nah, you can't do that. You just can't come to the neighborhood and start Bogart and say, like your motherfucking Columbus, and kill off the Native Americans. Right. Can't do that. What they do in Brazil, what they get to the indigenous people. You have to come on respect. There's a culture, there's people. You just can't move in and start. Here's another thing. When Michael Jackson died, they wanted to have a party for a motherfucking Fort Greene park. And all of a sudden, the white people in Fort Greene said, wait a minute. We can have black people having a party for Michael Jackson to celebrate his life. Who's coming to the neighborhood? They're going to get a lot of garbage. Garbage. Have you seen Fort Greene Park in the morning? It's like the motherfucking Westminster dog show. There's 20,000 dogs running around. Whoa. So we had to move it to Prospect Park. I mean, they just moved in the neighborhood. You just can't come in Bogarden. I'm for democracy and let everybody live, but you gotta have some respect. You just can't come in where people have a culture that's been laid down for generations, and you come in now she gotta change because you're here? Get the fuck out of here. Can't do that. So what's good about?
I agree with you. I agree with everything.
Whoa. Okay. And then, so what happens? So you talk about the people whose property change. But what about the people who are renting? They can't afford it anymore.
You
can't afford it. People want to live in Fort Greene. People want to live in Clinton Hill. The people who live on the Lower East Side, they moved to Williamsburg, they came for fucking Williamsburg now because of motherfucking hipsters. And now, and then what do they call Bushwick now?
East Williamsburg.
That's another thing, motherfucking. These real estate motherfuckers changing names. Stack the Heights. They're like the 110th, the 125th. There's another name for Harlem. What is it? What?
Morningside.
What is it?
Morningside.
No, not Morningside Heights. There's a new. What? What the fuck is that? How are you changing names? And we had the crystal ball and motherfucker do the right thing with John Snatcher's character. When he rolled his bike over, bugging out Sneaker. I wrote that script in 1988. He was the first one. How can I walk down Brooklyn with a Larry Bird jersey on? I can't do that. Not a best start. So, look. You might say, well, there's more police protection. The public schools are better. Why are the public schools better? First of all, everybody can't afford, even if you have money, it's too hard. Even if you have money, it's hard to get your kids into private school. Everybody wants to go to St. Anne's. You can't get to St. Anne's. You can't get into Friends. What's the other one? Yeah, but over in Brooklyn Heights, I'm talking
about.
Packer. So, if you can't get the child there into there, I mean, it's crazy. There's a business now where people, you pay. People don't even have kids yet, and they're taking this course how to interview to get your kid into private school. I'm not lying. So, if you can't get your kid into private school, if you're white here, and you can't afford it, what's the next best thing? All right, now we're going to go into public schools. So why did it take this great influx of white people to get the schools better? Why is there more police protection in Bed-Stuy and Harlem now? Why is the government being picked up more regularly? We've been here. It wasn't, we didn't have those services before.
All right, go ahead.
Let me see you come back to that.
I agree with every single thing you said. My
soul. No.
I let you talk. Now you let me talk. My one sole point, though, is wealth creation in the African American community. Something that we've traditionally been locked out of. You bought a house in the ghetto, and three generations the house was worth nothing in the ghetto. So for those homeowners that did stick in through Bed-Stuy, my parents moved in. It was all Jewish when they moved in. So I've seen it through everything. So for those people that did stick in, now we have an opportunity for wealth creation that we've been locked out of. So now, while that may not help the renters, and everything you said was absolutely true, what about that one aspect of wealth creation for people that have paid those taxes, that fought to keep the crime down on their blocks, and all the other things they did to maintain it? Because the white folks are not moving back because it's the ghetto. They're moving back because they are beautiful blocks full of beautiful brownstones that have been well maintained by people of color.
Yes. But here's the thing. To deflate your argument, sir. The people you talked about are not a great number. Number one, a lot of these people have not kept their taxes, so they can't afford to keep the house. Number two, when these real estate guys come around and open a suitcase with a bunch of money, they're going to sell it. Many of these people you're talking about are elderly. And if they get the money, money goes a lot further down south. Black people by droves in New York City is called reverse migration. They're moving to Atlanta, they're moving to North Carolina, they got a house, they got a lawn, they got a backyard, they have less taxes. And so, I mean, New York City is a hard place. And so if you worked all your life and you're retired, they're selling their houses. And I don't blame them. I can't say to them, you can't sell your house. They're like, fuck you, Spike. You know what? And rightfully so. I would never say that, but you have to do some research and look at the numbers. The population, the Black American population in New York City is going down.
Absolutely, yeah.
It's going down. This is reverse migration. And what we have is that, and it's something that Blasio is going to, I don't know, man, you can't get the snow on the streets, but still. What we need affordable housing for everybody. People can't afford it. I mean, here's the thing. The further away from Manhattan, Brooklyn Heights is the most expensive neighborhood. Then you got Park Slope, Fort Greene, Cobble Hill, Clinton Hill, and then, you know, it works like this. The rents get cheaper the further you go away from Brooklyn. And the reality is, after the sand on Coney Island, it's the motherfucking Atlantic Ocean. So, where are you gonna go? Where are you gonna go? Puerto Rican, same thing. A lot of Puerto Ricans have moved like to Bucks County or moving back to Puerto Rico. People can't afford to live anymore. And people can't afford to live, then it's going to be young artists like you. I mean, there used to be a time when you could get $200 a month to get by. You can't do it anymore. And so if New York City's not affordable, then the great art that we have is not going to be here because people can't afford it. So I know what you're saying, but I don't see a lot of good coming from gentrification for those people who live in those neighborhoods. Took that new name for the South Bronx now, what do you call it? What?
Sobro.
It's a scam. It's some shenanigans, trickery, people being bamboozled, led astray,
run amok.
It's you know, and what they call West Bushwick now?
East Williamsburg. And it starts around Rochester now, and it's crossed Broadway.
thank you. Yes.